Morning, gentlemen.
Morning, President.
Mr. Secretary.
President.
Bob, I bet you had a late night.
Sleep is for the weak, Mr. President.
Thanks.
Mr. President, CIA's been notified. McCone's on his way back from the West Coast. He's been burying his stepson. General Carter's here, though.
Ted? Kenny?
Okay. Let's have it.
Arthur?
Gentlemen, as most of you now know, you two over Cuba Sunday morning took a series of disturbing photographs. Our analysis at NPIC indicates that the Soviet Union has followed up its conventional weapons buildup in Cuba with the introduction of surface-to-surface medium-range ballistic missiles, or MRBMs. Our official estimate at this time is that this missile system is the SS-4 Sandal. We do not believe that the missiles are as yet operational. Ironbark reports that the SS-4 can deliver a 3-megaton nuclear weapon 1,000 miles. So far, we've identified 32 missiles serviced by about 3,400 men, undoubtedly all Soviet personnel. Our cities and military installations in the southeast, as far north as Washington, D.C., are in range of these weapons, and in the event of a launch, would have only 5 minutes of warning.
5 minutes, gentlemen.
In those 5 minutes, they could kill 80 million Americans and destroy a significant percentage of our bomber bases, degrading our retaliatory options. The Joint Chiefs' consensus, Mr. President, is that this signals a major doctrinal shift in Soviet thinking to a first strike policy. It is a massively destabilizing move.
How long until they're operational?
General Taylor can answer that question better than I can.
GMAC, Guided Missiles Intelligence Committee, estimates 10 to 14 days. Crash program could limit that time. However, I must stress that there may be more missiles that we don't know about. We need more U-2 coverage.
Gentlemen, I want first reactions here. Assuming for the moment that Khrushchev has not gone off the deep end and intends to start World War III, what are we looking at?
Well, Mr. President, I believe my team is in agreement. If we permit the introduction of nuclear missiles to a Soviet satellite nation in our hemisphere, the diplomatic consequences will be too terrible to contemplate. The Russians are trying to show the world they can do whatever they want, wherever they want, and we're powerless to stop them. If they succeed...
It'll be Munich all over again.
Yes. Appeasement only makes the aggressor more aggressive. And the Soviets will be emboldened to push us even harder. Now, we must remove the missiles one way or another. Now, it seems to me the options are either some combination of international pressure and action on our part till they give in, or we hit them, an airstrike.
Bob?
We've worked up several military scenarios. Before I ask General Taylor to take us through the various options, I'd like for us to adopt a rule. If we decide to strike, we must agree now to do it before the missiles become operational. Because once they are, I don't think we can guarantee getting them all before at least some of them are launched.
Well, it's clear we cannot permit Soviet nuclear missiles in Cuba. We have to get those missiles out.